Today, I'm going to show you how to create these Beauty and the Beast Enchanted Rose chocolates for your next party or get-together. I'm going to show you two different ways to make them and three different ways to finish them off. Okay, so for this Beauty and the Beast chocolate mold craft, we will need one Wilton silicone rose mold, or the plastic mold. It doesn't really matter, but I like the silicone ones because they're a little bit easier to pop the chocolates out of. We will need some pink candy melts, some red candy melts, some luster dusts in various colors, and you can do one or all of these. Two plastic piping bags that are disposable. We're going to use these to put our candy melts into. And it's really nice to tie these off with some bread bag ties. So then that way we're able to just use something that we already have for the piping bags. And then we need one brush for the luster dust. Let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is take our candy melts and take our piping bag. And we're going to pour the candy melts into the piping bag. Shake it down good. And then we're just going to twist the end. And then we're going to take our bread clip and we're just going to put it over the twist. And all of this is microwave safe so that we'll be ready to pop it in the microwave. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is put our cook time in for 2 minutes. And we're going to do this at half power level so that we can put our chocolates in, let them cook, knead them, and then every 30 seconds we'll bring it out, knead it up, and then put it back in. Okay, so after the initial 2 minutes, you'll see that half of the bag is melty and the other half is still whole. So we're just going to knead our bag up and then we're going to put it back in for 30 seconds at a time. Okay, so now that our chocolates are melted and they're at a nice consistency, we're going to go ahead and take the end of our bag, and we're just going to clear the chocolate away. Let me take this in so you can focus in and see that. And then we're going to take our scissors and we are going to cut the tip off. This will give us a perfect piping bag to be able to fill our chocolates. So we're just going to squeeze into our chocolate mold. Once we have our first couple roses in here, we want to go ahead and take the tray and just tap it and kind of jiggle it out. And that's going to get rid of all those air bubbles and it's going to get our chocolate to really set into the mold. And now we're going to do the same thing with our pink piping bag. We're going to cut the tip. And then we are going to pipe it into our mold. Once we have our chocolate mold completely filled up and tapped out so that all the air bubbles have come to the top of the tray and they won't be messing up our mold, we're then going to put it in the refrigerator and let it harden. Okay, so I just got these out of the fridge after them being in there for about 15 minutes to chill. And all we're gonna do is take our tray and just kind of wiggle it a little bit so it loosens the edges. And then we're going to flip it over and we're just going to pop our chocolates out of the mold. So as you can see, we got some really great looking chocolate roses, but I'm going to show you one other way to use this mold. Okay, so now that I have shown you the piping method, which is the way you will have to use the chocolate if you are using a plastic mold, let me show you another option you have if you have a silicone mold like this. Wilton has made it so that the silicone is able to hold up to really high temperatures. So because of that, we're able to actually melt some of the candy melts right in the mold and pop that in the microwave at power level 50 for 2 minutes. And then we can jiggle and tap just like we did before and then put it back in for 30-second intervals until it's all completely melted and all of the air bubbles have been jiggled out. And then we put it right in the fridge just like the other one. Okay, so as you can see, after we pull these out of the microwave, they're nice and melted, and now we just want to tap, 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 tap to make sure that we get all of the air bubbles out of the mold, and then we're going to put it in the fridge for the 10 to 15 minutes, just like we did the other style. Okay, so now that these have chilled in the fridge for 15 minutes, I'm going to go ahead and pop them out of the mold, and again, we're just going to kind of wiggle it to loosen the edges. And then we can push the silicone to pop it right out of the mold. A really great tip that you can use to be able to get all of the chocolate to be able to use it again is we can actually just seal our leftover candy melts in a plastic bag, and it can be sealed at room temperature and kept for a really long time, so be able to use it for projects to come. That way you don't have to waste any of your chocolate. And we just open up our bag and dump it all into our Ziploc baggie so that we will be able to use up any of this excess chocolate so that we're not wasting anything. And now it's ready to go for the next time we want to make chocolates. Okay, so now that we have all of our chocolates made, we're now going to really give them a sparkle and shine that really will give them the Beauty and the Beast feel by adding some luster powders. So we have a gold luster powder, a pearl luster powder, and a pink luster powder. Okay, so we are going to start with our gold luster dust, and you're just going to dip your brush into the luster dust and pat it off a little bit, and you just want to get some on the end of your brush here. And then we are going to dust our chocolates with them. Now I really like the gold luster dust. I think it gives a really nice fancy quality to the chocolate. It really just makes it kind of pop a little bit. And for a Beauty and the Beast chocolate, I really think it just kind of amps it up and gives you a little bit of that bell sparkle to the roses. Okay, and then if you are changing the luster dust, just make sure you're kind of using a paper towel to brush any extra sparkles off onto there. And then I'm going to show you how the pink looks. And we're going to do this on a pink chocolate. Now I will show you the pearl luster powder. Okay, so I just want to show you the slight differences. So this is a chocolate that has no luster powder on it at all. This one has the pearlized powder on it. This one has the gold powder, and I really love the sheen you get with the gold luster powder. And this one has the pink powder, so it just kind of made it a little bit shiny and kept its true pink color. But I just wanted you guys to really be able to see the different colors and patterns we get with the different shimmer powders. So just try out the luster powders. I really think they're fun, and they really amp up your chocolates from looking like something homemade to something that could be store-bought. Okay, well, there you have it. Our Beauty and the Beast Enchanted Rose chocolates. These will make a really great party favor, and we have them in two different colors, from the original animated feature in pink to the new movie feature in red. If you like this video, give me the thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. And we will catch you guys later. Thanks so much.